Hey guys, welcome back to Andy's Dinosaur Reviews. Today we are going to review a dinosaur figure that's been out for quite a while, and it is a Pappo figure. It is the Pappo Parasaurolophus. And I personally have always been a fan of this Parasaurolophus, even if he doesn't look probably how he really would in real life. He definitely, in my opinion, has a very Jurassic Park-inspired sculpt, but he still looks pretty good. And especially if you're a fan of that movie, I have been considering for so long to take one of these and repaint them, just to paint him like the Jurassic Park type of a paint job and see how he looks. I think he would look probably exactly like he looked in that movie. But even still, this is an absolutely beautiful rendition by Pappo of the Parasaurolophus, and he actually, I have a little buddy here for him, which is the same exact thing, but if you take a look at the two, you can see that the paint jobs are slightly different and vary in color, and that's because, as with all Pappo figures, they are hand-painted, and odds are one of them was released before the other, so over time the paint jobs tend to vary a little bit. So this one here may have been from the first run, and this one from a later run. I'm not completely sure, but I thought that it was pretty interesting that they differed quite a bit as far as coloration goes. And I'm not really sure which one I like more. I honestly probably like him a little more. I just think he looks a little better than the one on the right. And I've considered which one to repaint, and I just cannot decide, because I feel like because they're somewhat different, it's just so tough to decide which one I wouldn't want to keep and which one I would want to just repaint and make him a completely different looking Parasaurolophus. So one day I'll decide that. I don't know when. But like I said, definitely they differ quite a bit as far as paint goes. So if you do buy one, especially if you're going to buy one used, who knows what yours will look like. Someone similar to these guys, but you never know when it comes to Pappo. Another one of the things that I noticed that differ on these guys, if you look right here, there's a little symbol here on this guy's chest. But if you look at this one, he does not have that. And I'm not sure if anybody out there can answer me as to why that has changed on these guys. But it definitely has, and I know this one is definitely a Pappo or original. It is not a bootleg or anything. So, I mean, if it was a bootleg, that's the type of thing that would differ. It's definitely a Pappo original, but I don't know why they differ, not only in paint so much, but they also differ in the things that have been added to their sculpt. Now, if you're really looking to get sassy with these guys and create a little family for them, those beautiful bootleggers, of course, from China, have created something that you can add to your collection. Now, this is not a bootleg of the Pappo Parasaurolophus, although there are tons of those out there. They have definitely made those already, but I've never purchased one. It is actually this guy. It is a bootleg of the Schlike Parasaurolophus, but they took the Schlike Parasaurolophus and repainted it like the Pappo one, which I thought was very, very strange, but yet very interesting. So it's something that's kind of cool if you want to add a different Parasaurolophus that doesn't look the same as the Pappo ones to your Pappo collection. You can just go ahead and buy a nice little knockoff of a Schlike Parasaurolophus that just happens to have the pretty much exact paint scheme as the Pappo one. So definitely interesting of them to do that, but it makes it a nice little cool addition to anybody's collection. Like I said, if you want to create a little herd of Parasaurolophus, then have them all in the Pappo paint scheme. But bootleggers have already pulled one out for you. But anyway, let's take a look at the actual Pappos. Since they are the exact same sculpt, and obviously both Pappo originals, I don't have to actually show you both as far as reviewing both of them. They're the exact same sculpt, aside from that little logo deal here on the underside and the paint. So we'll just look at this guy as far as his detail goes. You can see looking up here at the head that the head is sculpted very nicely. Lots of beautiful little scales have been included and sculpted out. They look absolutely fantastic all over the place. And you can see just different types of shades and stuff have been put into the greens and the lighter, almost a yellowish type of a color that's on his face. And you can see a darker tan here near the mouth area. So beautiful job as far as the paint goes on this. And again, as far as the actual sculpt work goes, the beak here of the dinosaur looks beautiful. There has been some nice paint applied to that as well. And actually a little bit of a different tone has been put into it, so that gives it a little bit more of a realistic look. The inside of the mouth is colored beautifully, really it is. It's a definitely nice realistic color, and there's actually quite a bit of gloss inside the mouth, which is for some reason something I don't really see Pappo do too often. I feel like they don't ever really include gloss, but there is actually gloss inside the mouth of this one, so that does help bring it to life quite a bit. The eye has been sculpted very nicely. It's just a yellow eye with a black pupil. Some gloss has been added to that as well to also help it give it a nice little eye shine and help bring it to life even more in that aspect, as that does always help in my opinion. The crest has been sculpted beautifully as well. Very, very nicely done detail all over that. So great job there. Coming down here onto the neck, you can see some skin folds pretty much all over the place. So the skin folds look very good. Nice little scales all over the place. Very nicely done. Unfortunately, for some reason, mine has a little seam that you can see on the back of the neck and a seam up here on the top of the crest. But it's not something that's overly distracting. It's something you don't really see too often with Pappo figures. Looking down here into the shoulder area, you can see some beautiful sculpt work here, especially leading up here out of the shoulder blade into the dinosaur. That looks very good. The arms look beautiful as well. Very nice muscle tone here in this part of the arm. And again, the sculpt work down into the hands looks excellent. They look very, very good. Beautiful job done on the hands. The stomach also looks very nice. Sculpt work all over the place looks top notch. The little scales all over are different sizes, nice cracks, crevices. So very good job all over there. You've got some beautiful little skin folds protruding from the leg here into the stomach region, showing that the skin is connected to the leg and stretching a little. Some nice hip bones here on the upper part of the leg. Going down, you can see a little bit of muscle tone here in the upper part of the leg, and then some beautiful calf muscles down here on the lower part of the leg. Nice kneecaps sculpted out as well. The feet look very good. For some reason, the claws on the feet and the claws honestly on the hands don't really appear to be colored any differently than the rest of the body, but it doesn't look bad. It looks okay. You can see a very nice dark wash has been applied, especially to the legs, but overall it's pretty much all over the body, but it's really noticeable on the legs. Kind of like something that Schleich does, and you don't really see Pappo, in my opinion, do that too often, but it looks good, and they should probably do that more often, in my opinion. I really love that when companies do that. I think it just gives the dinosaur such that extra beautiful amount of realism. Going back here under the tail, there is just skin folds galore all over this tail as the tail is bent to his right, and you can see that the detail is carved out nicely to show that, and it looks beautiful the way they've done that. Very nice looking Parasaurolophus tail. The other side is pretty much the same way. It looks very nice. Beautiful skin folds here in the stomach area, going down into the lower abdomen, and then up here stretching into the leg. You can see where they connect again. The beautiful skin folds up here, just showing the type of movement that the dinosaur is in. You can also see them back here behind the hip as well. It looks very nice. The legs look pretty much the same on both sides. Beautiful muscle tone all over the place. So top-notch sculpt work on this guy. And again, the tail also has tons and tons of skin folds, really bringing this dinosaur to absolute beautiful realism. You can also see that there are some humps up here on the back of the dinosaur. And that's one thing that you really notice in the Jurassic Park movies, that they made sure that their Parasaurolophus had. And I think that's one of the big reasons, not to mention the pose kind of reminds me of Jurassic Park as they're trying to bring the Parasaurolophus down in the Lost World. It kind of gives me that type of a feeling. So definitely, in my opinion, Jurassic Park inspired, but that's not a bad thing as this Parasaurolophus does look beautiful. So those are the Pappo Parasaurolophus. I would not mind at all if they made a newer version of this just to see a more up-to-date Parasaurolophus, and maybe not one that's so Jurassic Park inspired. Again, I keep saying that, but it's not like it's a bad thing because I love Jurassic Park, so that's fine with me. But there's one thing that kind of bothers me about all these dinosaur companies is for some reason whenever they make a Hadrosaur, it's almost always a Parasaurolophus. Does anybody besides me notice this? I don't know why they do it, but they should probably start making some other ones. I mean, aside from Collect A has popped out a couple, but again, nobody's really seemed to release any in quite a while. Like, Collect A's are older, and they had a Lambeosaurus, Corythosaurus, so they had a few, but I feel like they're older ones, and nobody in the past couple of years has really released a beautiful new Hadrosaur, and I don't know why. It's something that I feel like these companies should do because I love them, and I would love to see some Hadrosaurs by these wonderful companies like Collect A and Pappo and Safari Limited. And even Schleich, I would love to see them create some newer ones, but for some reason, aside from Parasaurolophus, nobody's done any lately. But regardless, these guys, since we are talking about them, we'll get to their size. And he is about 7.5 inches long and a little under 5 inches tall. So a pretty good size, not a bad size at all. We'll get Mr. Papo T-Rex over here and bring him in for a size comparison. And there you go, you can see just how big they are together. They compare to each other pretty well. The Parasaurolophus is obviously shorter than Mr. Papo Rex, but it's not at all a bad size. Definitely a good size for a Parasaurolophus, especially if you're gonna buy it as a toy for your kid. So overall, I really do like the Papo Parasaurolophus. I think it's a beautiful model. And actually, before I even go on, I do wanna note one other thing that's different here in the paint job of these guys, is that for some reason, this Papo Parasaurolophus has gold eyes, and this older one has yellow eyes. That's another difference between the two that I actually had never noticed until right now. That's very strange. I kinda get the feeling that this guy here is definitely from the very first run or near the first run, and this one here is later. This was actually the first one that I purchased. I had purchased him a while back, but it was way after it was already released, so it could have been the second run, third run, I don't know. But this one here, I purchased in a lot of dinosaurs off of eBay. I paid like 50 bucks and it was a couple of years ago. I actually ended up getting a bunch of like the rare Papo dinosaurs that were all on this one little lot. I don't know if the person just had no idea what they had or what, but it was about $50 and I ended up getting this guy here, and I got like the brown Velociraptor and the green T-Rex and just like a whole bunch of them, like a whole bunch of Papos. And they were all the older ones, as you can tell, being the green T-Rex and the brown Raptor, they're older ones. But this guy was included with them, so I'd imagine that he was probably the earlier one, and they must have given him the yellow eyes back then, and then changed them now to gold and this slightly different color scheme. But don't take my word on that, I could be wrong. Anyway, but getting back to my point here, these Parasaurolophus figures are definitely very, very nice. I would recommend anybody to buy them. Unfortunately, they are in like a tripod-ish type of a pose, and I am more of a fan of them on all fours. I feel like they just look much nicer, but it's not that terrible. It still looks really, really nice. Papo, as always, does a great job on their sculpts. They look fantastic, so definitely a recommendation out of me. If I were to give them a rating, I would say probably like an 8 out of 10, just because of the fact that they are so Lost World Jurassic Park-ish, and me being a big fan of nostalgia, you can't help but to love that because I do love the Lost World and Jurassic Park. So anyway, yeah, definitely I will recommend you guys to buy these guys if you do like Parasaurolophus. I will put a link in the description as to where you can purchase these guys. And as usual with Papo, beautiful work, great job done. So please like, comment, and subscribe, and I will see you in the next review. Thanks for watching.